But I am upset today about this whole thing with Jamal Adams. You know, and I heard Chris Moore say, and I think he's a Jet fan. I don't know. Who knows? I think he is. I don't know. He says he's a Jet fan. I guess he is. And, you know, well, you know, the NFL is all about offense, and it's offense, and regular season's about offense. You want to talk about the defense in the playoffs? Okay. You know, Patrick Mahomes and on and on and on. I get it. You know, the fantasy football, of course. Let's, you know, so we'll get to offense, of course. So the New York Jets, who have been, without a doubt, the worst drafting organization probably in the history of the NFL. Now, Evan and I went over this. Clearly, the worst drafting organization over the last 10 years in the league. Over the last decade, they were the worst. The worst. Which, is anybody surprised about that? How could you be? Brutal. Brutal. So, the Jets, with all the terrible picks that they had in the first round over this decade, whether it's Kyle Wilson, whether it's D. Milner, whether it's Darren Lee, you know, whatever one of these, you know, horrendous draft choices, you know, even some of the second round guys like, you know, Stephen Hill, Jay Samaro, I mean, most of the second round guys, I should say. I mean, all these horrible picks, and I know there's plenty of guys that I'm leaving out, okay, plenty of those that I'm forgetting right now off the top of my head. All these lousy picks, you know, they finally hit on one. They hit on one. They hit on Jamal Adams. Maybe right now the best safety in the NFL. You certainly can make that case. You can make that case. And of the two units last year, the Jet defense under Greg Williams was by far the better one. It was actually a professional defense. Professional. And a bunch of, all due respect to the undefeated Miami Dolphin team, a lot of no-names on the defense. Most of these guys, I'm watching the games in the last year. Who heard of these guys? Phillips, Basham, Neville Hewitt, James Burge. I mean, who are these guys? And they played pretty well. They were good, really. But the best guy on the defense was number 33. The best guy on the team was number 33. But of course, and we all know the deal with him. He wants a trade. He says he wants to play for Dallas. He says he wants to play for Seattle. He says he wants to play for the Ravens. He says he wants to play for the Chiefs. He says he wants to play for, you know, whoever, the Montreal Alouettes, whoever he wants to play for. And it ticks me off as a Jet fan that he'll go to play for one of these teams without getting, you know, his contract redone, but he's not going to play. He doesn't want to play for us with the contract redone. So that gets me ticked off. And, you know, the Jets probably made a mistake, you know, shopping him, whatever they did last year, talking to other teams about trading him. That ticked Adams off. All of this, you know, the whole deal. And then the Jets basically saying they want Adams to be a Jet for life, and he construes that to be, well, now I'm going to get my deal, whatever. But the bottom line of all of it is he's the best player on the team. You finally hit the sixth overall pick in the draft. I think that's what the number was. You finally hit on it. You know, you got the real deal here in Jamal Adams. Real deal. And I know he doesn't play offense, and I know he's not a quarterback. He's a safety. Well, he can't pay. But, of course, the general knowledge, the general wisdom out there is, well, you can't pay a safety because it's all about offense in the NFL. Can't pay the safety. Can't pay him. Why? Because he's an impact player. Should you? And I'm not saying he's Ed Reed, and I'm not saying he's Troy Polamalu. And I'll just leave it at those two guys. I'm not even going to get to Ronnie Lott, okay? I'm not saying he's either of those two guys. But you know what? He looks like he has the potential to be that kind of guy. Let me a little more Polamalu than Reed, because Reed was like, you know, pretty much a straight ball hawk type guy. You know, the ball was up. You know, Reed always found the ball. He probably the best safety I've ever seen doing that. So I put him a little more Polamalu, a guy that could rush the passer, a guy that was a big hitter, you know, that kind of thing. Still makes his interceptions. You know, but the bottom line is he's an impact player. And you can count on less than one hand the amount of impact players that are right now on the New York Jets. And we kind of went down this road as well with Darrell Revis. I mean, we did. I mean, even I wavered a little bit. Well, maybe you don't pay Revis after he held out a couple times. You know, there always had seemed to be a contract situation with Darrell. Always. So, and then eventually the great John Idzik. Oh my God, I think they should name a stadium, a jet stadium after John Idzik. He does such a tremendous job. The great John Idzik. Great. John Idzik, who drafted D. Miller and Geno Smith. God bless him. What a job he did. And helped, grease the skids to get rid of Rex. So he did a brilliant job, Idzik. Brilliant. Brilliant. So he finally lets Revis go. They trade him to Tampa. And you knew it was only a matter of time. You know, he really wanted to wind up. Where? Of course, with New England. And, of course, he does. He eventually winds up there. And what does he do when he goes to the Patriots? He's there 1 year. What does he do? He wins the Super Bowl. Well, of course. Why not? Why wouldn't that be the case? We've seen that before, with a lot of different Jets. John Riggins comes to mind. But we won't even go too crazy. Keyshawn Johnson comes to mind. I don't want to go too nuts, going into that area, because it makes me crazy. But anyway, Revis does come back. He's not the same player. He had the one decent year, 2015. He was okay. He's okay that year. But he was still not the guy. There was no Revis Island anymore. That was definitely not what the situation was. So we all know what happened there. So now you got a guy who plays a unvalued position. Okay? We don't value it's his safety, you don't value it. You don't value it. But he's the best player on the team. He's an impact player. He's a guy that makes plays. Guy that makes plays. The guy that makes the most plays probably anybody on the team. So let's let him walk. Let's trade him to Dallas. Let's trade him to Seattle. Maybe we'll get a number one. Maybe we'll get two number ones. Maybe we'll get a number one and a number three. Maybe we'll get a one and a player. Maybe we could trade him to Dallas and get Zach Martin. Really? You think the Cowboys are trading Zach Martin for Jamal Adams? Stop. You kidding? I heard one caller with Chris and the great JJ, who, of course, can't wait to get Jamal Adams out of here. Being a Dolphin fan in years, you think he wants Jamal Adams on the Jets? Come on. He's dying to see Jamal Adams go play for the 49ers. You don't want him. You don't even want him in the conference, but let alone in the division. Big Dolphin fan that he is. And I don't know what Chris, get rid of him, Chris, because he doesn't play offense, And if he was a running back, a great running back, you'd say the same thing. Oh, but he's a running back, they're a dime a dozen. So you got an impact player on a team. You got to get this done. I'm sorry. You got to get it. You got to find a way. You got to find a way. Because if you do trade him, how do I know you're getting anything close, especially, and we don't know what Joe Douglas is yet. The jury's out on Joe Douglas. Maybe this draft was a great draft. It better be. God knows that. God knows that Becton and Mims and the great safety they drafted, what's his name, Davis, right? The guy, oh, my God, the one they got with the Giant pick that does everything. He's like the Swiss Army knife of all time, right? He's already the best safety in football, hasn't even got there yet, and he's a third-round draft choice. You know who I'm talking about. Unbelievable. The hype on him was like, oh, my God. How did everybody else pass him up for over two rounds? What value? So, maybe you say, okay, well, look, we got this great safety now, this Davis guy, right? I think that's his name, Ashton Davis. Got this great safety, so we could let Jamal go, right? They're going to let May go anyway, but maybe, him too. We got Davis. So you got an impact player on your team, and you can't wait to freaking trade him. It just makes me delirious with this franchise. It really does. And again, I don't know what Douglas is. This draft better be off the charts. It better be stellar. It better be as good a draft as they had when they got the Brick and Mangold in the first round. At least it better be. Something along those lines. That would be good. So we don't know what these guys are yet. And I don't know what Joe Douglas is yet. But really, Joe, can't you find a way to keep the best player on your team? Isn't it time for you to go maybe fly to wherever he is, Dallas, wherever he is right now, and go sit down with him and say, Jamal, we want you here. I mean, go face to face, okay? Put your mask on. You don't want to get too close. God forbid we do that. Plus, if he goes to Texas, they spiked. It's spiking in Texas, so you got to watch out. So you got to make sure you wear your mask, Joe, okay? And Jamal, you too. Maybe get a little plexiglass between the two of you while you're sitting down and talking, okay? Make sure you wash your hands. And sit there and hack out and find a way to have an amicable conclusion to this where – this guy stays a Jet. Stays a Jet. And I don't want to hear his safety. I don't want to hear you can't pay him. I don't want to hear any of that. I don't want to hear he's not a quarterback, or he's not a wide receiver, or he's not a he's not a pass rusher, you know, or he's not a corner, or he's not a left tackle. I want to see this guy on the team because you know what he is? He's an impact freaking player. That's the bottom line. Impact player. Case closed. Period. So I implore Joe Douglas to go out there and find a way to get it done with this guy. And I know you got control of him for the next 2 years. And I don't know if it's even going to be football. Who knows? I don't know if there's going to be any sports. I really don't. I'm concerned about it all. Thank God I'm watching golf right now. Thank God. I got Bryson DeChambeau in my pool. He's five shots back. He had a good day today, but not as good as Mackenzie Hughes. Shot a 65. I'm watching highlights of him now. But the whole thing with Adams just makes me crazy. I want Jamal Adams on my team. I want to keep a guy that I actually finally hit on in the draft. I want to see him long-term with the Jets. That's what I want to see. And I think you can do it. You know, it's all going to be about the money. He's talking about this. You know, he'll play for the Jets. Take care of him. But Joe Douglas, the first thing you got to do is get on that plane. Or if you're afraid of flying right now, get in a car. Take a nice cross-country drive from wherever you are in New Jersey. Like I said, make sure you got your mask. Make sure you got the hand sanitizer. And go sit down with Jamal Adams and get it done. Case closed. I don't want to hear about trading him. I don't want to hear about you can't pay a safety. Get it done with Jamal Adams.